If there's one thing I've learned about facelifts in recent years is that they don't do much to change a car's exterior design. This holds true for the 4 Series convertible as well, which gained only a few nips and tucks. In fact, if you've already seen the coupe version of the 4 Series, you've pretty much seen the convertible below the waist, as the upgrades are unsurprisingly identical. Arguably the most important revision to talk about is the new lighting system. Previously sold with xenon headlamps, the 4 Series convertible now sports LED lights. The cluster design is also different, but not by much. The fog lamps also use LED technology and are now standard in this configuration. Around back, the Bimmer has LED taillights for the very first time. BMW also talks about modified air intakes in the front bumper and model-specific trim in the rear apron, but these changes are so mild that they're barely visible. On the other hand, each of the 4 versions, Advantage, Sportline, Luxury Line, and M Sport get their own specific wheel designs. The facelift is rounded off by 2 new exterior colors. Snapper Rocks Blue and Sunset Orange. Both of which are exclusive to the 4 Series line. If you're expecting to find significantly more new features inside the cabin, you'll most likely end up disappointed. Now, I'm not saying that the 4 Series convertible is poorly equipped, just don't look for too many extras compared to the outgoing model. The first thing you'll notice is the double stitching on the dashboard. This is a nice touch as it enhances the cabin's premium feel. BMW also added a center console in high gloss black and new chrome trim on the dash and door panels. These are joined by 3 new upholstery colors and 3 new interior trim strips, which means you have more ways to customize your car. New upholstery colors include midnight blue Dakota, cognac Dakota, and white Dakota leathers. New interior trim includes carbon aluminum, light fine line, and high gloss black with pearl chrome. The styling add-ons stop here, and if you want other extras, you'll have to look under optional on the technology equipment list. First up is the professional navigation system, which features an interface with large tile style control pads. This makes it easier to use, as the pads can be arranged as desired and display a constantly updated version of the menu content. Then there's the optional multifunctional instrument display, which brings new visualization options specifically tailored to the driving mode selected. Under the hood, the 4 Series convertible continues with a wide range of drivetrain options. Specifically, there are no fewer than 31 different model and powertrain variations, including 4 and 6 cylinder engines sipping either gasoline or diesel. It may sound a bit complicated, but it's not that terrifying once you figure out which trim uses which engine. The gasoline lineup actually includes 3 badges. There are the 420i and 430i, which are equipped with the 2.0-liter 4-cylinder, and the 440i that gets the 3.0-liter inline 6. The 420i cranks out 181 horsepower and up to 214 pound-feet, while the 430i generates us out 249 horses and 258 pound-feet of twist. The 440i, which is the range-topping non-M version of the drop-top, comes with 322 and 332 pound-feet of torque on tap. These engines are paired to either a manual or a dual-clutch transmission, while all-wheel drive or xDrive in BMW torque is optional. Although not available in the United States, the M4 convertible gets 3 diesel powertrains in Europe. First up is 420d A2.0-liter 4-cylinder, good for 187 horsepower and 295 pound-feet of twist. More oomph comes from the 430d version, which uses a 3.0-liter 6-cylinder engine tweaked to generate 254 horses and 413 pound-feet of torque. Finally, the 3.0-LiTeR 6-cylinder in the 435D model sends a solid 309 horses and 465 pound-feet of twist to the wheels. Transmission choices are similar here, with the 6-speed manual and 7-speed dual clutch to choose from. The xDrive system is optional on the 420D and 430D but comes standard on the range-topping 435D. As far as performance goes, getting to 62 miles per hour from a standing start ranges between 7.6 and 4.7 seconds. The 420i is the slowest of the bunch, while the 435D xDrive is the quickest. Yes, the diesel is 3/10 quicker than the 440i gasoline model, which makes it even more frustrating if you live in the US and want the fastest 4 series convertible. Pricing for the revised 4 series convertible starts from $50,550, which is a minor $550 premium over the outgoing model. For that amount, customers will take home the rear-wheel drive 430i model. For AWD, you'll have to add an extra $2,000. The more powerful 440i comes in at $57,500 with RDW and about $59,500 with xDrive AW. While the 4 Series convertible is already 4 years old as of 2017, the C-Class Cabriolet was brand new for the 2017 model year. Taking cues from the latest S-Class Cabriolet, the compact drop-top blends sporty and elegant design features and is regarded as one of the sexiest convertibles on the market. The interior is almost identical to the C-Class sedan and coupe, but it comes with its very own comfort features, including the air scarf neck heater and the air cap automatic draft stop system. Under the hood, it gets a wide range of gasoline and diesel engines, but in the US, it only comes with the 2.0-LiTeR turbo 4 rated at 241 horsepower and 273 pound-feet of torque with either RWD or AWD. Pricing starts from $50,900, which makes the C-Class Cabriolet very competitive against the 4 Series. Around since 2009, the first generation A5 Cabriolet was finally redesigned for the 2017 model year, giving us a third option in this niche. Built around the previous model styling-wise, the new A5 convertible boasts a more aggressive appearance with sharper body lines. The interior is brand new with Audi's new continuous air vent strip dashboard and latest technology. Under the hood, Audi offers 4- and 6-cylinder options. The 2.0 TFSI trim comes with 252 horsepower and 273 pound-feet of twist, while the base diesel, the 2.0 TDI, cranks out 190 horses. Moving over to the range-topping diesel version, the 3.0 TDI, it gets 216 horsepower. Pricing starts from $49,600. Comparing the German premium compacts to the Chevy Camaro might have seemed ridiculous a few years ago. But the pony car has come a long way as GM upped the ante in just about every department, including moving it closer to the premium market. Redesigned for 2016, the current Camaro is also more compact and significantly lighter, which makes it in more of a sports compact rather than a traditional muscle car. Inside, we find softer materials, better fit and finish, and GM's latest generation MyLink system with improved connectivity and features. It also has a LED ambient system that comes with a unique 24-color package and a theatrical mode that cycles randomly through the entire color spectrum when the car is parked. It also has a turbo 2.0-LiTeR 4-cylinder engine that delivers 275 horsepower and 295 pound-feet of torque alongside unprecedented fuel economy for a Camaro. The 3.6-liter V6 cranks out a competitive 335 horsepower and 285 pound-feet of twist. Pricing starts from $33,695 for the 4-pot model and $35,190 for the V6, both stickers being significantly more affordable compared to the competition. For less than $45,000, you can actually order the V8-powered SS model, which offers M4 competing levels of performance at 455 horsepower and 455 pound-feet of twist. When it was launched in 2013, the 4 Series convertible was miles ahead of its competitors. It had way better technology, more fuel-efficient engines, and its design was fresh and modern. 4 years have passed and things changed dramatically in the compact premium segment. Granted, the 4 Series is still an appealing two-door with cool gadgets and strong performance, but BMW has two new rivals to worry about. Mercedes-Benz launched a brand new C-Class Cabriolet, while Audi just unleashed the redesigned A5 convertible. It's going to be tough for the 4 Series convertible. But the German machine appears to have what it takes to survive for another 3 years among stiffer, newer competition.